The Poco M2 Pro has an attractive design and it's built well. But it's also look very similar to the Redmi Note 9 Pro. It features a P2i water repellent coating, which is said to make it flash proof. Poco has used a 6.67 inch Full HD Plus LCD display with a cutout from the selfie camera. But also get Gorilla Glass 5 on the front, back and the rear camera module. One feature that are missing is an high refresh rate. The Poco M2 Pro runs on MIUI 11, which is based on Android 10. And my unit has the Zoom security pass. Apart from having the Poco launcher as a default, the features and functionality are very similar to what you get on Redmi device. MIUI and app performance are superb thanks to the Qualcomm Snapdragon 720Z. Navigation through MIUI interface felt snappy, multitasking worked well, and apps in general were quick to load. Gaming performance was very good too. The 5000 mAh capacity easily lasted for an entire day even with a lots of gaming and camera usage. The Poco M2 Pro has 4 rear camera, which included primary 48MP sensor, an 8MP sensor with a wide angle lens and a 5MP macro camera and a 2MP depth camera. You get a 16MP hole punch selfie camera. Overall, the camera of the Poco M2 Pro performed decently under good light, but struggled to deliver satisfactory result in low light. Poco has been very selective about its smartphone profile. It was spun off from the Xiaomi and launched the Poco X2 more than a year after Poco F1, rather than the releasing flagship class such as the F1. The company is now focusing more on the budget segment. With the new Poco M2 Pro, it aims to take on the 15,000 rupees price segment. Poco says it has seen tremendous success with the X2 and hope to replicate that formula. Thanks for staying with us and subscribe my channel. Thanks.